Let's go on and do the Florida Gators. I'm all in on this. All right. I know that you're not, but we'll talk about it.
Okay.
I
don't know that I'm not.
10-3 last year, 5-3 in conference, returning starters that got 5 coming back on offense, 7 on defense. Experience, number 52 in the country coming back, number 5 in the conference. Dan Mullen, 79-49 in 10 years as a coach. That's at Mississippi State and last year. Was only the third coach. 1940 Stanford's Clark Shaughnessy. In 2013, Auburn's Gus Malzahn did this as well. The one of only three coaches to win 10 games with a Power 5 school the year after they won 4 games or less. That's pretty impressive. That's high company. Now, the circumstances were a little different because there were so many people suspended last year. There was so much drama. All this kind of mess. Coach fired in the middle of the year. Just a mess. Quarterback Felipe Franks, leading rusher LaMichael Pirine, and all three top wide receivers return, but they're replacing 4 out of 5 guys on the offensive line. Quarterback Emory Jones, probably going to be used as a weapon more often this season. His videos, like his training videos, yep, have been pretty remarkable, but obviously...
Dude's an athlete.
Yeah, he's an absolute
beast. He's a freak.
Beast. Yep. Yeah. Defense, they kept defensive coordinator Todd Grantham. The Cincinnati Bengals came calling for him, and Florida gave him a $300,000 raise. And it was probably money well spent because, I'm telling you, his aggressive 3-4 scheme was awesome last year. And it's been pretty awesome basically everywhere that he's gone.
Oh, yeah. Ever since he left Louisville for Mississippi State to come with Dan. And yeah, he's been really, really good.
He's been pretty unbelievable. He was at Georgia for a year. And then he went to Louisville. And then he went to Mississippi State. Sure. Now he's at Florida. I mean, it's just, you know, he's been all over. But everywhere he goes, they get better. People may not like his style. Like, he's fiery. He'll get after you. He'll get all up in there. But he's an excellent coach.
That's
he
right.
fits very well with
Dan. Nobody's going to argue that.
They're replacing defensive end Polite. They need to develop depth at defensive tackle and linebacker. They got the culture and the locker room back in year one, but a lot of offseason drama. And, you know, they're ahead of schedule, but they are not up to the level of Alabama and Georgia and LSU as of yet. Now, yes, I get it. They beat LSU, but long-term...
Just being able to chalk up wins, know where you're at, the stability of the program.
Yes.
It has nothing to do with wins and losses.
You are correct. I have got Florida at 9-3 this season. There is a reason why their over-under is at 9. The over is plus 160. The under is minus 180. Vegas thinks that they are going to hit 9. Like, that's either 9 or under.
Not
either
9
and 3 or 8 and 4.
Getting to 10 and 2, we think, is pretty drastic.
Yes. I've got them losing to Auburn. I've got them losing at LSU. I've got them losing at Missouri. And then that's it. I've got them 9 and 3. I think they beat Tennessee at home. I think they get revenge on Kentucky on the road. I think they win at South Carolina. I've actually got them beating Georgia this year. But a lot of that has to do with the state of the two programs and where I think Georgia might take them lightly, especially if they lose to Auburn and at LSU early. They may not take them as seriously as they normally would. Now, I could be completely wrong on that.
I don't know about
They could beat Auburn and lose to Georgia.
That's it.
Either way, I think 9-3 is pretty good. I think it's really good for this team.
I think they're going to be 9-3 as well. It wouldn't surprise me if they're 8-4 just because I think they've got a tough run. You've got them losing at Missouri. I think they could lose that South Carolina game. Don't know if they will. Here's my thing. I think if they lose to South Carolina, they'll beat a Georgia, an LSU, an Auburn. They'll beat one of those bigger, tougher schools. I just think kind of that's how the chips are going to fall.
Yeah.
I don't know exactly where that loss is going to come in at or where that big win is. I do think they start the season off with a big win against Miami. I think that's a big deal in week 0 that they're calling it. Dan's a good coach, and when he has multiple weeks or time to prepare, you know, he doesn't often lose. So that's we see that very similar. If I was going to bet this, the juice is pretty heavy on the under, but I don't see a world where they go 10-2.
No. It's the only bet to make would be the under.
And you pay the high juice.
Yeah, you pay the high juice and then go from there. Now, if they hit 10, we'll come back.
Oh, no, I could be wrong. I mean, yeah, I've been wrong before.
I don't see it before the season.
Having skill players, but see, I see football different than a lot of people, and I don't get caught up in the fact that you bring all these athletes to town. If you don't win in the trenches, you can't win, especially in the SEC.
And they are not set up
and to do that. They're inexperienced, and they're young in the trenches, and they've had chaos and drama and turmoil in the offseason. Yeah. I don't know what that means. That's actually very rare for a Dan Mullins coach team. So I don't. Of course, he was only there for 1 year. Maybe the chaos is he's there. He's bringing a little bit of law and order, a little bit of ruling with an iron fist, and players can't handle that. I don't know.
Or maybe he just doesn't know how to handle like highly rated recruits. Yeah.
No, you're right on that.
He's not really used to them.
What he's used to is taking 2 and 3 star talents
and coaching them up
and helping them play on Sundays.
Yeah.
And everybody knows their name when they're done as seniors. But nobody knows their names as freshmen.
Now at Mississippi State in the later years, like they were able to get Jeffrey Simmons, they were able to get Leo Lewis, but you had
to build the program to that point. And you're talking one or two blue chip players in a locker room full of guys that nobody wanted and had to fight for everything they have, as opposed to Florida's locker room, which is everybody was supposed to be there. Yeah. Everybody had a big chip next to their name. And they're 4-star talent all over the field.
Now you're right. You're right. So I've got them 9-3. You've got them.
I got 9-3 also. I don't dislike this team. Or I mean, I don't like Florida. They're a rivalry of ours. But I don't. I mean, I don't. You know.
I don't
think they're going to be bad. No, I don't know that 8-4 is total chaos. They play LSU and Auburn on that side. I mean, that's brutal.
LSU, Auburn, Georgia. At South Carolina,
Missouri, and they open with Miami. Yeah, and they open with Miami. Their road schedule is not easy.
No, it is not. So 9-3 would be really, really good for this year. Yeah. Really good.